Only fools pledge life to honor.
Welcome back, Lord Lovers, to another journey through the rich tapestry of Runeterra's legends. Today, we delve into the shadows of Noxus, where danger lurks in every alley and betrayal is as common as the night. Our focus turns to one of the most enigmatic figures in the Empire's history, Talon, the Knife in the Darkness. Talon's story is one of survival amidst the brutality of Noxus' streets. A merciless killer, he moves with precision and cunning, striking fear into the hearts of his enemies. But his path to infamy was not an easy one. Forced to kill, fight, and steal to stay alive, he honed his skills in the crucible of violence that is Noxus. Yet fate had plans beyond mere survival for Talon. Adopted by the infamous Ducuto family, he found himself thrust into the deadly world of Noxian politics and intrigue. Now he serves the Empire with a cold and calculated efficiency, eliminating its enemies with ruthless precision. This is the tale of a man forged in darkness, a weapon of Noxus whose blade strikes true and whose loyalty is as sharp as the edge of his knife. Welcome to the story of Talon.
Live and die by the blade.
In the depths of Noxus' shadowed alleys, Talon's story begins, shrouded in darkness and sharpened by the edge of a blade. Bereft of familiar warmth or kindness, he found solace only in the clink of pilfered gold and the cold embrace of the walls around him. Survival in the seedy underbelly of Noxus demanded more than mere existence, it demanded mastery. And Talon mastered the art of the blade with a skill that set him apart, marking him as both a threat and a target. Assassins came for him, sent by Noxian guilds seeking to harness his little talents. But Talon was no pawn to be manipulated. He met their challenges with cold resolve, leaving their lifeless forms as grim warnings to any who dared cross him. Yet, it was a fateful encounter with one of these would-be killers that altered the course of his destiny. In a clash of steel and strength, Talon found himself disarmed and facing certain death, but fate intervened in the form of General Ducuto, revealing himself as Talon's would-be executioner. In a moment of decision, the general offered Talon a choice: death or service to the Noxian High Command under his command. Talon, recognizing in Ducuto a formidable opponent worthy of respect, chose the latter, binding himself to the general's will. Thus began Talon's life as a shadowy agent, a silent instrument of Noxus' will, carrying out clandestine missions that spanned the breadth of Runeterra. From the icy tundras of the Freljord to the hallowed halls of Demacia, his blade struck unseen, his allegiance unwaveringly to Ducuto alone. But when the general vanished without a trace, leaving behind only questions and uncertainty, Talon's loyalty was put to the ultimate test. Obsessed with uncovering the truth behind Ducuto's disappearance, Talon now roams the land, a solitary figure in search of answers. His journey takes him to the darkest corners of Runeterra, driven by a bond forged in the crucible of conflict and tempered by the fires of loyalty. For Talon, the shadows hold not only danger, but also the key to unlocking the mysteries of his own past and the fate of the one he swore to serve.
Eventually, my blades will find their way into your heart.
Talon's memory is a blank canvas, devoid of familial ties or confronting embraces. Surviving in the shadows of Noxus, he relied solely on his cunning and dexterity, scrapping together a living through thievery in the city's underbelly. With each passing day, he delved deeper into the labyrinthine underground passages, honing his skills with the blade until mastery became his own. But as his reputation grew, so too did the threat he posed to the Empire. Marked as a danger, assassins were dispatched to silence him. However, they underestimated the resourcefulness of their target. Talon turned the tables, dispatching his pursuers and disposing of their bodies in the depth of Noxus' moat, a chilling testament to his resilience and resolve. Talon had an interaction with Katarina in a mission that had the objective to kill her. This story is called The Name of the Blade. In the Cloak of Shadows, Talon stands. The scent of copper tainted the air as fresh blood mingles with the darkness. His senses are keen, every muscle taut with anticipation as he observes her, Katarina, in her element. As she moves, dispatching her foes with a deadly grace, Talon is reminded of the teachings they both received, though their paths to mastery were vastly different. While she was born into privilege, he earned his place through greed and survival in the unforgiving streets of Noxus. Yet, despite their disparate backgrounds, they share a bond, a familial tie forged through adoption by General Ducuto. In this chamber of opulence and peril, he watches Katarina weave her little dance, her blades flashing with deadly precision. To the untrained eye, she may seem trapped amidst her adversaries, but Talon knows better. He recognizes the calculated patterns of her strikes, the subtle nuances that betray her lineage and training. She is formidable but flawed, her arrogance a chink in her armor. Memories flood his mind as he observes her. Memories of another encounter, another time when their fates collided in the cold embrace of a forest. He had been tasked with her elimination, a mission meticulously planned and executed, but fate had other plans, and his strike, though precise, did not bring the desired outcome. Instead of succumbing to defeat, Katarina rose from the ground, wounded but unyielding. What followed was a duel of blades and wheels, each of them testing the limits of their resolve. In her eyes, Talon saw determination, a refusal to accept failure as her fate. And in that moment he made a choice to spare her, to defy the expectations of duty and honor that bound him. As Talon watches her now, a lone figure amidst a sea of fallen foes, he is filled with a sense of resignation. The bond between them is undeniable, a thread woven through the fabric of their shared history. And though he may be duty-bound to return and face judgment for his failure, Talon cannot deny the truth that lies between them. With a heavy heart, he retrieves the blade that once sought her demise, its name a silent testament to the complexities of their relationships. Katarina, a name that carries the weight of their shared past, a reminder of the choices they have made and the path they have yet to walk. When it comes to relations, Talon found himself thrust into a tumultuous situation when his father, General Ducuteau, assigned him with the daunting task of eliminating his stepsister, Katarina, following her initial failure. However, Talon's attempt at assassination proved unsuccessful, resulting in a scar etched into Katarina's left eye as a haunting reminder of their shared past. Instead of seeking redemption through further attempts, Talon chose to bear the weight of his failure, recognizing the hypocrisy in pursuing Katarina's demise after his own botched attempt. In a curious display of empathy, he bestowed upon the blade used in his failed assassination the name of Katarina herself, keeping it close at hand as a silent testament to the complexities of their relationship. Should the grim duty of eliminating his stepsister ever be reassigned to him, Talon stands prepared, his resolve tempered by the knowledge that their intertwined fates cannot be easily untangled. About Katarina, I have already made a video, you can go and check it out. And yes, what I can say is that Talon is right to be amazed by her. Katarina's formative years lacked the comfort of kindness, as every waking moment became a relentless quest to forge herself into the ultimate weapon. She tested her endurance, dexterity and pain tolerance to understand the nuances of poisons she pilfered concoctions from the city's shadiest apothecaries, incrementally building resistance while documenting effects. Scaling towering structures under the cover of night became routine, her movements unseen by prying eyes. Driven by a fervent desire to contribute to Noxus, Katarina yearned for an opportunity to showcase her hidden strengths in service of the Empire and its throne.
The worst part of losing a blade is trying to trace back all my stabbings.
Thank you for joining us on this immersive journey into the dark and complex world of Talon's story, Lord Lovers. If you found this exploration of Noxus' shadows captivating, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to stay updated on future lore videos. Join our Discord channel for more in-depth discussions and connect with fellow lore enthusiasts. Together, let's continue to uncover the mysteries and intrigue of Runeterra's rich tapestry of stories. Until next time, may the lore guide your path.
Your allegiances mean nothing to me.